We've all seen images like these. Beautiful, glamorous, sexy women selling us an ideal, a lifestyle, or even happiness.
These ads are all too familiar, but what about advertisements like this? Or this? Between the 1950s and the 1970s, the number of female wage laborers doubled, and their presence in the wage economy has increased steadily since then, with obvious implications for their spending power. Studies suggest that in the post-industrial era, more women are entering the educational system. Currently, there are more women in universities across Canada than men. This means the workforce will be more female-oriented than ever, adding to their amount of disposable income and dragging behind it the $471 billion advertising business. This increase in female consumers means a new market for advertisers to explore.
How have these advertisers broken into this new market? By serving up sex on a silver platter.
The pornographication of men is becoming imminent in today's society. Just as products suggest an extension of the owner, male sexuality is also used to reflect power, class, control, and ideal.
As Brian McNair explains in Striptease Culture, conventional gender characteristics in males are lustful, strong, predatory, and dominant, whereas females are loving, weak, protective, and submissive. I think McNair might have missed these.
As these roles are now shared by both sexes, advertisers are using this to their advantage. Just as women's bodies have been used in the past to sell products, men's bodies are now being used for the same reason. Products are often placed alongside erotic images of men that reflect today's hypersexual culture. The term that has surfaced in the advertising world is one of porno chic. McNair states that it is not porn, but the representation of porn in non-pornographic art and culture. Journalist Jeanette Kufferman notes, there is scarcely an image, entertainment, fashion, or advertisement untouched by pornography.
The erotic male is the stereotype for the ideal man. He represents a physical and sexual ideal that consumers typically buy into. The objectification of males is becoming a prominent technique in the advertising world. The pecs, abs, and genitalia are emphasized. His gaze is often emotionless and empty, and he is usually gripping something in a strong, masculine way. Advertisements also present sexually vulnerable and willing males as offerings to the female consumer.
Meet the erotic male. This Lacoste ad depicts a nude man with a coffee. Although what this ad is selling is actually cologne.
This Louis Vuitton ad shows the empowered woman on top, hiding the man's face and treating him as an object.
These Sky Vodka ads exemplify how women have reversed the typical dominant role of men.
And perhaps the most obvious depiction of the erotic male is shown in these Slurpee ads.
Ladies and gentlemen, the pornographication of men in advertising has arrived. Oh, and P.S. The ad campaign is called Something Juicy for the Women.
And some of these ads aren't only directed towards women, but to another market that paved the way for the eroticization of the male. Gay men. Dina Rollinger noted in her journal that in 1984, major firms began actively pursuing the gay dollar. It was believed that gay consumers were young and robust with large discretionary income, upscale tastes, and strong brand loyalty. Although advertisers struggled with the notion of gay advertising, and even though they did not all agree at once, they decided that this was a market they could not pass up.
In the 1980s, the AIDS crisis struck, and advertisers were afraid of the stigma that accompanied the image of gay men. Manufacturers collectively stopped marketing to the gay population. Through the 1990s, gay advertisement saw a rise due to the gay liberation movement, mainly characterized by their claim of public space, protests, gay rights groups, and public education media campaigns. The growing acceptance of homosexuality led to an expenditure of $155.3 million in gay advertising in 1999. The gay dollar is on the rise again.
Je prends mon temps, je marche sur toi. Tu passes devant, je regarde tes yeux. Je t'aime l'amour pour aujourd'hui.
It's not just commercial ads that are using pornographication to sell an image, but Hollywood is picking up the trend as well. Singer Jerry Halliwell's latest album objectifies men by placing them in outfits ironically similar to Playboy bunnies.
More interestingly is the iconic character of James Bond in the series 007. In 2006, the James Bond franchise turned the tables in the film Casino Royale and featured the star Daniel Craig slowly emerging from the water in nothing but a blue Speedo, a scene that was historically something a woman would do. The scene was undoubtedly inserted to please the woman audiences and again shows how the male body is used in a more sexually progressive way. Advertising changes with society. Today, more women than ever are working, going to school, and living independent lives. As we've shown, advertisers have begun marketing to this new woman. Society is more open to diverse ideas, dependent on various technologies, and hold different values than ever before.
Men are being viewed in a more sexually progressive way. We see the male image evolving from a dominant archetype to a mere sexual object in many cases. In today's hypersexual culture, there are no holds barred, no barriers, and no market left untouched. So prepare yourselves to see much more of the erotic male. She's a man.